morning and welcome back again in the Relief Tutorials classes. In the last lecture of science, we have seen about two types of spherical mirrors, concave mirror and convex mirror. Concave mirror having the inner surface is reflecting and convex mirror having the outer surface is reflecting. In the concave mirror, the center of reflecting surface was called as pole, and this is the pole for convex mirror. We have also discussed that these mirrors are actually made from one of the hollow sphere. The center of this hollow sphere is now called as center of curvature. The same logic you can use here also in the case of convex mirror also. This is center of curvature again. If you pass the imaginary line from C and P, so this line is called as principal axis. Here also you can draw the principal axis like this. Exactly in between C and P, we found principal focus. We have discussed that if we place the object at the infinite distance, the rays coming from the infinite distance are always parallel to principal axis. They reflect and concentrate here at one of the point on the principal axis, and which is called as principal focus. In the case of concave mirror, the principal focus is real, and in the case of convex mirror, the principal focus is behind the mirror. We have drawn the diagram also that if we pass the ray like this, the rays are reflected and becomes divergent. So they can be extended behind, and we found the virtual principal focus. So in the case of convex mirror, the principal focus is virtual, and in the case of concave mirror, the principal focus is real. Now the distance between C and P. Distance between C and P means from pole to center of curvature is called as radius of curvature in both the cases. And the distance between principal focus and pole, this distance in both the case is called as focal length, symbolized by F. This we have done already. Now the new topic for today is how we can form the image. How we can form the image in front of concave and the convex mirror. We have already drawn the diagram for the image formation by plane mirror. But today's topic is about how to form the image in front of concave and convex mirror. But before going towards that, let us see some rules for reflection. Let me repeat again, let us see some rules, not the laws. Laws we have already seen for reflection, which are applicable for plane mirror, concave mirror, convex mirror, all the kinds of mirrors. Based on those laws, we have rules of reflection. The topic is, rules of reflection for spherical mirrors. First rule, rule number one. Mind it, these rules are based on the laws of reflection. Let us see the first one. First of all, consider this is one of the concave mirror. This is one of the concave mirror. What is this? This is pole. Here is center of curvature. And here exactly in between these two, principal focus. Now, first rule, if the incident ray, is coming parallel to principal axis, if the incident ray is coming parallel to principal axis. So the reflected ray will always pass from principal focus. First rule, if the incident ray is parallel to principal axis, then reflected ray is passing from principal focus. This rule is valid for both the types of spherical mirrors, for concave also and for convex. Let us see for the convex. Consider this is one of the convex mirror. This is principal axis, pole, center of curvature and principal focus. If the incident ray is coming parallel to principal axis, we know in the convex mirror that the ray will be diverged from this point. It is not going really from it because the ray is not going to pass from mirror. So this will be the reflected ray. So this ray is going like this. If you extend them behind virtually, it seems to be passing from F. Let me repeat again. Here is the incident ray in front of convex mirror. Incident ray, we can see that this is parallel to principal axis. And according to rule, if the incident ray is parallel to principal axis, it will reflect from principal focus. Here the incident ray is parallel, reflected ray is passing from principal focus. Here in this convex mirror case, incident ray is going parallel and going diverge, is going away. But if you extend it behind, it seems to be passing from principal focus. So we know that this principal focus in the case of convex mirror is virtual. So this is the virtual passing of ray from principal focus. But the rule is same. Incident ray parallel to principal axis, reflected ray will pass from principal focus really in concave and virtually in convex. The reflected ray is passing from principal focus really in concave and virtually in a convex mirror. This is rule number 1. Rule number 2. Rule number 2 is exactly opposite. If the incident ray, rule number 2, if the incident ray is passing from principal focus, means F. I am drawing the rule number 2 ray by red color, not drawing the different diagram. This is the figure for rule number 1, and now rule number 2. If the incident ray is passing from F like this, this is the incident ray passing from F in the case of concave mirror. So the reflected ray will be parallel to principal axis. If the incident ray is passing from principal focus, reflected ray will be parallel to principal axis. Exactly opposite to rule number 1. This is incident ray, so the reflected ray will be like this. This is the reflected ray in the case of concave mirror. Exactly opposite to. But now here in the convex case, the incident ray should pass from F. But how can the ray pass from F? Because F is already behind the mirror and ray will not pass from mirror. So it is like this. The incident ray seems to be passing from F. It is pointing towards F. But obviously it will not pass from mirror, so it will pass from it will pass really from F. It seems to be passing from F, so it will reflect parallel to principal axis. Let me draw one more ray for you. Consider this is the ray, incident ray. This is the incident ray, seems to be passing from F, so it will reflect parallel to principal axis. So the rule number 1, if the ray incident ray is parallel to principal axis, it will reflect from F. Rule number 2, if the ray is going from F, coming back L. Going parallel, coming from F. Okay, going from F, coming parallel. Exactly opposite, these two rules are important rules. Third rule. Rule number 3. In the rule number 3, if incident ray, is passing from C, center of curvature, then reflected ray will also pass from C. Means what? If you see a ray, let us say this is one of the ray going from C, and you see that these rays are, this is the incident ray, this incident ray is exactly going from C. So such type of rays will be reflected exactly in the opposite direction, and it will again pass from C. It's very easy to remember that if the ray is going from C, coming back from C, bounce back. In the case of convex also, this is convex mirror, this was concave, this is pole, principal focus and center of curvature. If incident ray seems to be passing from C, it will reflect back. Simple and easy to remember. If the ray is going from C, coming back from C. What was the first rule? First rule was, if the ray is going parallel, coming back from F. What was the second one? If the ray is going from F, it will coming back parallel. What was the third one? If the ray is going from C, it will come back in the same opposite direction. Rule number 4 and the last one. Rule number 4. If the incident ray is pole, principal focus and C. If the incident ray is striking at pole, this is point of incidence, this is concave mirror. If you see carefully, at this point of incidence, this principal axis behaves as normal at the point of incidence. So I think this angle, this is incident ray and this is normal. So these angle is angle of incidence. Angle of incidence is here. So according to laws, the ray will be reflect like this, forming same angle of reflection. We know the law, angle of incidence is always equal to angle of reflection. So if the ray is striking at the pole, principal axis itself behaves as normal. So angle of incidence found here and angle of reflection will be same as the angle of incidence. In the case of convex also, it is same. This is principal axis. Here is pole. If the incident ray is striking at pole, this is normal, so this angle is called as angle of incidence, and this ray will be reflect in such a way that it forms the same angle of reflection following the laws of reflection. So these are the 4 different rules for reflection for spherical mirrors. It's very important rules for forming the image. So now the topic is about image formation by concave mirror. Just let me recap. If you remember that we have placed the plane mirror like this, we have placed the object like this, and we found the image here exactly behind the mirror. If you remember, we have drawn this diagram, we have discussed this twice. The image was virtual, the image was erect, the image has same size, image has same size as the object. ये सब हमने देखा है. थर्ड वन वॉज वॉट द डिस्टेंस ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट फ्रॉम द मिरर कॉल्ड एज यू, डिस्टेंस ऑफ इमेज फ्रॉम द मिरर कॉल्ड एज वी. दीज टू डिस्टेंस ऑलवेज रिमेन सेम. नाउ इफ यू टेक दिस ऑब्जेक्ट दिस इमेज, इफ यू टेक दिस ऑब्जेक्ट नियरर द इमेज ऑल्सो कम्स नियरर. देयर विल बी नो डिफरेंस इन द साइज, there will be no difference in the any of these characteristics. The image always remains virtual, always remains erect, size always remains the same. If you stand in front of the plane mirror, the size of your body is equal to size of the image. If you come closer, the image seems to be coming closer. If you go away, the image seems to be going away. All this means all the characteristics always remains same, so there is no variety of image formed by the plane mirror. But in the case of spherical mirrors, we will have varieties of image, different characteristics. So we have to take many cases, we have to place the object at many different places to find out the variety of image formation. Let us see. So the topic is about now image formation by, first of all, concave mirror. We will see the image formation by convex mirror also, but right now it is concave. Let me tell you about the different cases. Let me form a table here. Position of object, then here is what position of image, nature and size. Nature and size both of image. Okay, the first position in the concave mirror, let's place. See, we have what the topic is. We have to place the object at different places in front of concave mirror, and let us see how the image changes. The first one, this is pole, principal focus and center of curvature. Consider it is a concave mirror. We already discussed that if you want to form the image of any one of the point, to form the image of any one of the point, we require two rays. We have to incident two rays, reflect them according to rules, and we have to find out where they are meeting. The image will be formed at the point of intersection of those two rays. Let us see. First position, where they are going to place the object. This is the concave mirror, this is reflecting surface. We have to place the object in front of it. In the first case, let us place the object at the far distance. So if you place the object at the infinite distance, Yes, in the last lecture we have seen that if you place the object at the infinite distance from the mirror, then it will be what? The rays will come parallel to principal axis. So the first one, position of object at the infinite distance. At the infinite distance. So we are placing the object at the infinite distance, and now let us see how the image is formed. Natural thing, if the object is at infinite distance, rays will be parallel. We require only two rays. First ray goes like this, parallel to principal axis. Recently we have seen the rules that if the incident ray is parallel to principal axis, the ray will be reflected from F. Simple. Now second ray. Now if object is at the infinite distance, so obviously the second ray also will be parallel to principal axis. There is this one. This ray also will be reflected from F. So these two rays are parallel to principal axis and both are reflecting and passing from F. So we know the image will be formed at the point of intersection of two reflected rays. So here is the point of intersection of two reflected rays. And if you see, this point is exactly at the principal focus itself. See again, the point is F here, and on the F the image is formed. So where was the object? Object is at the infinite distance. But where is the image? What is the P? P here for position. I am not writing the full name. Position of image. Can you see that the position of image is at F? So position of image is at principal focus. Now nature. Can you see that both these two rays are really meeting? They are not virtual, they are real. So the nature is, nature means you have to tell either the nature is real or virtual. So here the rays are meeting really. So nature is real. And we know that if the image is real, it is always inverted. Real and inverted. Now what is the size? Nature means you are telling either the image is real and inverted or virtual and erect. So here the nature is real and inverted. Now look at this point A. This point is exactly on the principal axis. If, just imagine, if this point of intersection is not on the principal axis, it may be here. For example, if the point of intersection is here, then we can say the image is like this. If the point of intersection is here, then we can say the image is like this. But here, the point of intersection is exactly on the principal axis, means there is no size. The size may be like this or may be like this if the point of intersection is not on the principal axis. But here the point of intersection is on the principal axis. There is no size. So we can say the size of image is point-like. Point-like, highly diminished, whatever the word you say. So this was the first figure. First position, that if you place the object at the infinite distance, the ray will come back from F, nature will be real and inverted, and size is point-like. Second, now in the first case we have placed the object at the infinite distance. Now let us bring the object closer. Not too close, but let us take somewhat closer. Let us say this is the object now. Not too far, but it is still beyond C. Beyond C, away from C. So the second position is, position of object is beyond C. And now if you want to form the image, you have to pass two incident rays. Let us say the first ray goes according to rule number 1. We know the rule number 1, that if the incident ray goes parallel it will pass from F. According to rule number 1, we have passed one incident ray and corresponding reflected ray we have obtained. Now second ray we have to pass, we have four different rules, if you remember. We have four different rules, but we have to pass only two rays. So whatever the rule you can follow, let us see the third rule, if you remember, that if you pass the ray from C, if the incident ray is passing from C, it will reflect back like this. So this is the point C, this is incident ray and this is reflected ray. So two rays passed. Now what to do? You have to find out the point of intersection of reflected rays. Find it by yourself. If you see this incident ray, this is, so to find out the point of intersection of reflected rays, you have to just focus on the two reflected rays only. The first reflected ray is like this and second reflected ray is like this. So we can have a point of intersection of reflected rays here. So I think this is image. This is the image. We can see that this image is inverted and obviously real. So the position of object is beyond C. But where is the position of image? Can you see that this image is between C and F? So the position of image is between C and F. What is the nature? Nature is obviously real and inverted. And what is the size? Size is, I think, smaller than the object. Smaller than object. Second case. Third case.